not even on. It's not even on. Hey, how you doing? How's everything? How's everything?
Good, good.
All right.
All right. Welcome to Lady Tiger Basketball right here on the TSU Sports Network. Nick Strong alongside Akil Williams, Marcus Smith on the sidelines. Let's go to him just to start this thing off. Here we go.
Guys, Lady Tigers won big against Alabama A&M. We always talk about Joyce Kennison. She's averaging over 20 points for the Lady Tigers. But one of the things we're looking for from them is who's going to be that definite second option. Last game, Caitlin Palmer had 19 points. We're looking to see if she can do some of the same things tonight as they play against the Lady Braves. Guys, back to you.
And there it is. And there it is to start things off here inside the first quarter. TSU Sports Network. That was Marcus Smith with the first sideline report. Akil, let's talk about it real quick. The Lady Tigers come into this contest sitting in second place right behind Grambling. They're playing for playoff standings here. They're playing for playoff situations. On the other side, the Alcorn State Braves, they're coming in, and they're going to be led by senior Henrietta Wells as well.
I think if you talk about TSU, the Lady Tigers know they went on the last two road games they had was on the Alabama road trip, and they know how important that road trip was for them to not only be the defending champs of Alabama State, but to backdoor and beat a team that had nothing to lose in Alabama A&M. They could have came in lackluster, but they had a great performance led by Caitlin Palmer having 19 points in that game. And for Alcorn State, they're battling for that fifth spot. This is a must-win for not only the Lady Tigers, but for the Lady Braves as well.
It's going to be a big game tonight here. Doubleheader action coming your way. Women's first, men's second. The big first-place matchup in the men's contest. 2-0 your score here. Alcorn with the early lead. And let's get you your starters real quick. Number three, Joyce Kennison, Shamiah Brooks, Trina Ewing, Caitlin Palmer, and Breasia McElrath to start things off here for the Lady Tigers. On the Alcorn State Lady Braves, Henrietta Wells, Brianna Lutton, Alexis Freeman, Miracle Rushing, and Aisha Kirkling. As Alcorn start things off here, they go from right to left on your computer screen. And Henrietta Wells going in strong, and here's the rebound by number 22, Breasia McElrath. Tigers trail at 2-0 here. And they come up with the Alcorn State Lady Braves come up with a quick steal. Here's a quick shot. And no good. Rebound Brooks. Sakil, let's get into the keys to victory here for the Lady Tigers.
We talk about the Lady Tigers. You got to get Palmer rolling early. You seen last game against Alabama A&M. She had double digits only in the first half only. She finished that game off with 19 points. That's key number one. Key number two, have patient offense. Be patient on offense. Set your offense up. Get your half-court offense rolling. Don't rush at all. You back at home. First of the last two at home before playoff time, set up your offense. Number three, win open shooting. We've seen a lot of times in the last few games for the Lady Tigers, Trina Ewing, Caitlin Palmer, they would not shoot the ball when they had wide open jump shots, even on a fast break. It was always Joyce Kennison. And the key player I have is Caitlin Palmer. The last two games she had was on the road, 16 points per game. The last two games she had. To help out Joyce Kennison scoring, Caitlin Palmer needs to be that second score that the Tigers is looking for.
And Joyce Kennison to the basket. She just got five quick points right there. I can say that quick enough. 5-2 your score here in favor of the Lady Tigers of Texas Southern. Here's Henrietta Wells from the top of the key, and she misses. Rebound last touch of the bounds by the Lady Braves. It will be TSU basketball. I got a chance to see the Alcorn State Lady Braves and Southern Jaguars this past weekend. The Braves come in, they look pretty good. They're gonna play a tough ball game as well.
Yeah, you talk about that game with the Lady Braves. They fell to the Southern Jaguars, 45-33 in that matchup you talked about.
Last time these two teams met, Texas Southern won 57-53. Joyce Kennison had 24, Alexis Freeman had 16. 10 left on the shot clock. Here's Palmer. Palmer takes a shot. And rebound Wells. China Ewing comes away with a steal. Trying to go coast to coast. Shot is blocked. Loose ball. Great job by Brooks to get it to Ewing. And misses the wide open layup. Here's McElrath inside the lane. And she can't put it in. Brooks going back up strong. Count there the bucket. Go. Two quick offensive rebounds. And nevertheless, 2 points for the Tigers.
And you like what you see from China Ewing. Usually you'll see China Ewing take the steal and back up the offense. But you've seen her go up. Even though she got blocked, you like the aggressiveness right now from China Ewing.
The leading three-point shooter on the Alcorn State Braves misses the three-pointer, Brianna Lutton. Tigers come back down the court. Going from left to right here. Here's Ewing. Kinnerson, no. And last touch out of bounds by Breasia McElrath. McElrath can sure jump out the gym.
Girl's an aggressive player. We always talk about Breasia McElrath. On this road trip, got a chance to know the players a little bit more, and that's just her personality. She's always an aggressive person, an aggressive player. Braze McGrath's one of the better players on this Tigers team.
Akeel Williams and Marcus Smith got a chance to go to Alabama last week or this past weekend.
Great experience. Great experience to know the team, know the state of Alabama. That's my first time going to Alabama, by the way, too.
Here's Sanders with the finger roll, high off the shot clock. Out of bounds, TSU basketball. As we get into Caitlin Palmer into the front court here. Trying a quick door pass to Kinnerson. Kinnerson, count it. Two more points for Joyce, the sophomore from Port Arthur, Texas. Let's get into the keys to victory for the Braves.
We talk about the keys for victory for the Alcorn State Lady Braves. Make someone else beat you. Get the ball out of Joyce Kinnerson's hands. Everyone in the SWAC knows TSU's first option to score the ball is Joyce Kinnerson, averaging over 20 points per game in SWAC. Most likely player of the year in the SWAC, leading this Tigers team to a top two seed. You got to let somebody else beat you. Is it China Ewing? Is it Razor McRae, Shamar Brooks? Anybody but Joyce Kinnerson to beat you. Force the Tigers to take tough shots. Let them get them to tough positions, because we've seen a lot of times for the Tigers where they will start off good in the first quarter. And nice move by Octavia Ford. Start off the game good, but then second quarter comes, or late in the first quarter, they have droughts. They'll take tough shots. They will tend to force a lot of things, and they will have turnovers for the Tigers. At number three, pressure, pressure, pressure. Get a lot of pressure on TSU. If you've seen the press for Alcorn State, get in the press. Let somebody else drip inside Joyce Kinnerson and Caitlin Palmer. Get China Ewing the ball. Just get the ball out of Joyce Kinnison's hand and pressure the Lady Tigers.
11-4, your score. Lady Tigers lead it by 7 here early on. Still the first quarter. TSU sits second place in the SWAC. In line of HOSA, first round SWAC contest next week. Here's Palmer. Buckets! 14-4, your score.
And you see right now at Alcorn State, they'll press you, but then they'll back up in the zone, forcing TSU to take jump shots.
Here's Hargrove. Freeman. Freeman driving. And a quick foul. As we have our first media timeout of the contest, the Lady Tigers lead it 14-4. We'll be right back. You're watching Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. TSU off to a good start here, 14-4, and it's none other than Joyce Kinnerson leading the way.
And this is what you tend to see right now with TSU. Get the ball in Joyce's hands a lot of times. give her the live possession early in the first quarter. Let her get going. Let her get going to have other people like China Ewing, Kaylin Palmer, feed off of that energy. Because we all know Washington TSU play all season long. Joyce will give you 10 points easily in the first quarter. So Joyce Kennison off to a high start like always, 7 points. Kaylin Palmer, 3 points off that first three of the game for her. So I'm liking what TSU's doing right now.
Alcorn, on the other hand, not looking so good here early on. Just no answer just yet for these Lady Tigers.
Well, it's going to start off with Alexis Freeman. Last four games of Alexis Freeman, shot only 29%, going 21 for 61, 10 points per game. We talk about Henrietta Wells, one, the second best player in my eyes on this Lady Braves team. But it starts out with the junior, Alexis Freeman. The ball's in her hands all the time. And that's a key match we got to look forward to. Joyce Kennison versus Alexis Freeman.
Here's Henrietta Wells. Just under 4 minutes left to go here in the first quarter. Kirkland. Here's Freeman. Dribble drive. Shot is up. No good. Air ball off the foot. Rebound. Lady Braves, and Kirkland can't put it inside the bucket, but Henrietta Wells with the finish.
You got to find a way to box out Henrietta Wells under that paint. She's been doing it for a long time in the SWAC already. One of the better rebounders. You got to find a way to box her out.
Great pass by Kennison to Artavia Ford. In the lane, 16-6. The Tigers still lead by 10.
And Joyce just went down that paint and said, what is a press? A press do not mean nothing to me. Let me feed it all to Artavia Ford for the sweet down.
Here's Freeman with the shot from outside. No good. Loose ball. Here comes Mikhail Raff. The Braves fighting over it, and they're going to have to reset. 16-6. Sanders to Freeman. Freeman into the lane. Freeman with the reverse. And the Lady Tigers come away with it. Let's go live on the sidelines to Marcus Smith.
Hey, Nick, Akil. Over there at the media timeout, Coach Janetta Hayes Perry was talking about defense, keeping your hands straight up. She doesn't want them to lose the game because of silly foul. She says, play fundamental defense, keep your hands up as Kirsten hits a three, and stop number 15, Alexis Freeman. Talk on those screens. She wants to get into that pull-up game. Don't let her take advantage of those. Back to you guys.
And thanks a lot there, Marcus Smith, on the sidelines. 19-6, your score is Joyce Kennison. Pulls down another three here early on for the Lady Tigers. Kennison leads the way with 10 points so far. Here come the Braves. Here's Freeman. Reverses around to Sanders. Eight left on the shot clock. Here's Sanders. No good. Rebound Joyce Kennison as she runs into McElrath. She can do it on the offensive side and she can do it on the defensive side. She grabs boards as well.
Exactly. And the thing for Lady Braves right now, it's not that he's just getting dominated, doing anything wrong, because they're pressuring TSU. TSU's just making contested shots and getting wide open jump shots off the zone. They're pressing TSU is not working. They're in the zone. Joyce Kennison's making everything that's in her way. So it's nothing that Alcorn State is just doing wrong necessarily. It's just the fact that TSU's are making open shots and contested shots as well.
19-6 your score, and the Lady Tigers are trying to give Grambling a good run here for the first place spot. Two losses by Grambling.
Great pass.
And two wins by the Tigers could possibly put the Lady Tigers in first place. Quick two by the Alcorn State Lady Braves. Joyce Kennison just drives through the double team in the backcourt.
It's like watching Trey Jefferson when they try to press him. We talk about it in the men's game. We're going to see later on tonight. They try to press Trey Jefferson. It's not going to work. And Alcorn, they trying to press Joyce Kennison. It's not going to work, obviously.
Right side. Here comes Ewing. Ewing inside to Ford. And I think she's whistled for the three-second violation.
Just a minor mistake for Artavia Ford. Sometimes you got to get your feet out the paint and just have your IQ up on times like that. You see, you try post play. A lot of post players love to get the ball in the paint sometimes, and they just forget about 3 seconds of the key.
Let's take a look and see. Out of bounds, last touch by the Tigers. It will be Braves basketball under their own rim. Got a lot lined up for you tonight here, TSU. It's Greek night, School of Communications night, our school.
Great night of basketball all around. Greek night, shout out to the Greeks. School of Communication, our building, MLK building.
Here's Lutton, and Lutton off the top of the rim. Ewing calling for Kennison. Just about 30 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Tigers lead it by 11. Henderson inside to Ford, and Ford just can't hang on to it. I thought she should have put up the alley-oop right there.
They'll take her for it. She can go up there and get out. I've seen her in practice a lot of times. Not necessarily dunking the ball, though, but she'll throw a lot of dimes out there before. But if you're Lady Braves, you're the coach of Lady Braves, you have to find a way to have offense. You have to find a way to get momentum on the offensive side of the ball. You have to get off because they are in a drought right now.
Yes.
They're down 11. They only have 8 points, and you cannot be down like this early in the game if you're going against a team like the Lady Tigers.
19-8, and the Alcorn State Lady Braves trying to score 10 before they go into the first quarter huddle. Here's Lutton. Lutton driving. Looks right side. Rushing. Rushing loses it. Lutton gets it right back. She's going to have to let it fly. Here comes Brooks with the steal. And great job by the Lady Tigers to defend that last possession there in the first quarter. 19-8, your score. Lady Tigers lead it. You're watching Lady Tiger basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. Welcome back to Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. Nick Strong alongside Akeel Williams, Marcus Smith, and the Ocean of Soul sounding ever so good here on Communications Night and Greek Night inside the H&PE Arena. Lady Tigers led by head coach Janetta Hayes-Perry trying to get her Lady Tigers back to the SWAC tournament this year. And they will be in a SWAC tournament. Here's Kennison to the lane, up and under, and a traveling violation. Akeel Williams, the Lady Tigers just haven't been able to pull it out in the past couple of years into the tournament.
They haven't pulled it out. You've seen last year they lost to Southern in the semifinals, and it was crazy. It was ironic that TSU women lost, started the day off losing to Southern, and at the end of the day, the TSU men lost to Southern. So it was just Southern's year in the SWAC last season. But TSU, I think this might be the time that TSU can probably get over that hump, but they got to watch out for Grambling. That's in Louisiana right now. They're the hottest team in SWAC.
Well, that's also going to be the reason why the TSU Southern game is going to be important this Saturday night. It's going to be very upbeat around this neck of the woods.
A capital V-E-R-Y. Because you want to get vengeance off that loss last season, because that's the last game before tournament time before you play your quarterfinals here. And I know Janetta Hayes-Perry did not forget about that matchup last season.
And the Tigers will be hosting a game Tuesday night, doubleheader, 5:30 and 7:45. And an offensive foul there by Breasia McElrath of the Lady Tigers. It'll be a big game here Saturday. The Lady Tigers will probably be facing, I think it's going to be maybe Prairie View or Valley on Tuesday night. That's going to be a big one.
And that's a question you ask yourself sometimes, Nick. If you're the Lady Tigers, who would you rather face, Prairie View or the young up-and-coming team in Valley? Because we've seen Valley. The turnaround from last season is incredible because Valley is a team that almost had them in this gym last couple of weeks back. But a Prairie View team, I feel, is a better matchup for TSU. But I feel like they could win either team. But I would rather face Prairie View if I'm the Lady Tigers.
Alexis Freeman knocks down a deuce. 19-10 your scores. They cut the lead down to 9. I would like to see a TSU Valley. I would like to see a TSU PV. We saw, like you say, we saw Valley last weekend. We saw PV. That was a good one. Would you rather take out PV first or meet them in the championship round with the rivalry on the line? You know what I'm saying? So there's a lot of storylines to that. Here's McElrath trying to go inside. The ball is stolen. Here come the Lady Braves.
And I think when you talk about that, Nick, I think when you want to see a PV, would you rather see PV early or later on? I think knock them out early. Because I rather want, personally, I want to see the number one and two team, Grambling and TSU. I feel like that's a storyline, a rivalry a lot of people not talking about. And I feel like they have the best player matchup in all of SWAC, combined men and women, with Shaquille Hill and Joyce Kennison. That's one of the conversations you ask, hey, who's the better player? Who's the best player in SWAC? Is it Joyce Kennison or is it Shaquille Hill? They both came in the same time. They both sophomores. Both are similar as a player and a point guard. So I'd rather see knockout Prairie View first or Valley and then play Grambling in the championship.
Brianna Lutton knocks down the 2 for the Alcorn State Lady Braves. Cuts the lead to 7. Here's the quick pass to the entry. Henrietta Wells coming away with the steal. Joyce Kennison tries her, and she can't put it in. Here come the Lady Tigers back on the push across the timeline, going from left to right. Kennison to the lane. No. And Kennison just couldn't put it in. Joyce Kennison leads all scorers with 10 points here in the first half. We're in the second quarter right here. On the opposite side of the basketball, the Alcorn State Braves. 4 players tied with 2 points.
I think right now, a key stat for me right now is points in the paint. We see 10 for TSU and 6 for Alcorn. But that's due with Alcorn playing zone in that first quarter. You see in the second quarter, they switched it back up to man because TSU was knocking down a lot of jump shots. And we look at the field goal percentage, 8 for 16 shooting that first quarter for TSU, going 50% along with 3 for 6 shooting from three-point range. And then you got Alcorn State, 4 for 16, shooting 25%. And they didn't get to the lane. Both teams didn't get to the free throw line, so we just seen just now with Joyce Kennison. But if you're an Alcorn, you have to find a way to get consistent offense if you want to beat the Lady Tigers and stay in this game.
Henrietta Wells to the lane, guarded by Brooks. Henrietta Wells with the finger roll. And I think she's whistled for the 3-second violation, actually. 21-12, your score. Lady Tigers lead it. And here's a timeout early on by the Lady Tigers. It's going to be a media timeout here. Let's take a break. Lady Tiger basketball on the TSU Sports Network.
Uptown Diamond offers an
Welcome back to Akeel Williams. Marcus Smith on the sidelines. TSU leads it 21-12. It's been the Joyce Kennison show thus far.
Joyce Kennison show, like always, 12 points in the first half. I would love to see her score another 20-point game because I'm so accustomed to seeing her scoring 20 points. You know, so it's easy in her sleep, but great performance right now in the first half for Joyce Kennison.
Getting SWAC Player of the Week just isn't enough for you, huh?
SWAC Player of the Week, the month, I want the year.
Here's Ewing. Tigers showing a little motion right here. And an offensive foul. It's going to go against number 22, Breasia McElrath. As I think she used a little bit too much body there.
And I think sometimes it's hard to revel back around. Because I've seen a couple of games against Alabama A&M.
She plays hard.
And
that's her natural game.
Exactly. And they call charges sometimes, or they call off the fouls on McElrath. But it's just because she's going so fast and she's so powerful. So it's kind of hard to ref McElroy.
Here's Wales, back down by four. Wales with a nice move. And Wales just couldn't finish as Nicole Smith comes into the contest for the Lady Tigers. Lady Tigers lead it by 9, 21-12. Lady Tigers looking good here early on. Kinnerson going inside the four. Quick steal by Wales. And Wales just plays that inside better than a lot of other big defenders in the SWAT.
Wales, I could say, she's the most fundamentally sound post player in the SWAT. Just watch, she just need to finish the ball. She just need to finish sometimes.
Yeah, she does. Yeah, you're right.
So we've seen the move she put on our table before, the up and under, but she just got to finish down the left side of the goal.
Henrietta Wales, a senior from Memphis, Tennessee. She'll be playing in her last SWAC tournament this year. And Joyce Kennison will be playing in her second SWAC tournament. Here comes Ewing. And great block there by Henrietta Wales. Henrietta Wales, 6'1". Averaging 2.9 blocks per game this year. Leads the team. But here's her downfall, 11 foul outs. Here's Ford. Ford just can't put it inside. Sanders trying to go coast to coast, and she's whistled for the traveling violation. Excuse me, check that, Gabrielle Jubenville. Actually, Tori Spann. Senior from Wichita, Kansas. China Ewing going baseline looking for Kinnerson. Kinnerson into the lane. Looks back for Ewing. Ball is stolen. And Nicole Smith is knocked down to the ground. Here come the Braves. And I thought she got all ball, but the ref said otherwise.
I call it both ways. It looks like we had a lot of calls that was going towards both ways. Actually, if you go about the last part, I was scoring. It looked like to me it was a pro hop or a Euro step, but they call it a travel. Sometimes, you know, it's 50-50 in the swag. Sometimes they'll call it, sometimes they won't.
Miracle rushing to the free throw line on the season, shooting 45%, 42 for 85. She misses the first. Miracle rushing all the way from Meridian, Mississippi. She's a junior. She's a 5'9". Here's a free throw. Count it. 21 to 13, and the Braves cut the lead to 8.
And as you see, the Braves on the chip into the lead a little bit. They're knotted down 8. Now it's time for the Lady Tigers to find some offense, find some consistent scoring right now outside of Joyce Kennison. Look for Octavia Ford or Kaylin and Kaylin Palmer to get into this game and get involved more.
Here's Kennison. Trying to set up Palmer. No. And rebound. Here's Spann. Spann will have to reset. Tigers in man. Here's Henrietta Wells with the no-look pass to Lutton. And I think she's whistled for the traveling violation.
Another traveling call for the Lady Braves. They have to find offense. Look at the stats right now, 6-for-21 shooting. Only shooting 28.6% from the field. A key scorer, Alexis Freeman, 4 points on 2-for-7 shooting. They have to find some offense right now. Alexis Freeman, we know it's not a Joyce Kennison. She has to lead the Lady Braves and try to chip this lead in and cut the lead down a single digit.
Kaitlyn Palmer puts it in for 2. Extends the lead back to 10, 23-13. Here's Wales. Shot is blocked by Palmer. Kinnerson on the run. She wants to pull up. And Octavia Ford has it and just couldn't save it. Last touch out of bounds will be Braves basketball.
So great block by Kaitlyn Palmer to hustle. A guard getting up there to block a post playing Henrietta Wells. It's not easy out here. It's not easy for these guards to get up there and block a 6'1 post player in Henrietta Wells that had a great roll to the basket but did not see Kaitlyn Palmer when she tried to lay the ball up.
Here's Sanders. Guarded by Smith on the baseline. Looks outside, Miracle rushing. And just couldn't put it inside, in and out the rim. Lady Tigers back on the run. Here comes Ewing. As she lets it go to Palmer. Lady Tigers lead it by 10. Just under 4 minutes left to go here. Kenderson to the lane. And last touch out of bounds by the Braves. Tigers playing some dribble drive here. Palmer's getting some open looks. Just can't place it right where she wants to place it.
And Palmer told me we was in Alabama. It's kind of weird. It's a weird superstition, sort of. She said she's better at knocking down jump shots when she got a hand in her face more than a wide open shot, which is kind of weird because if you're wide open, you got to make that shot. But she said she likes to shoot when people's in her face.
And here's Artavia Ford with two defenders in her face. Count the bucket, 25-13, and the Lady Tigers extend the lead to 12. Palmer went for it, and she got caught with her hands in the cookie jar.
Got some hands caught, try to steal the ball, try to gamble. She'd love to see the hustle from Kayla Palmer, because right now in this first half, she's playing great defense right now. You've seen the block she put on Henrietta Wills, and she also has a steal in this game.
Talking Lady Braves here. They trail 25-12 by 13. What are some early adjustments you think that head coach Courtney Pruitt may need to make for these Lady Braves here early in the first half?
Well, I think you need to they get into the lane. It's been a couple of possessions. They get to the lane, they get good shots, but they're just not making them. As we've seen Tia Sanders make the jump shot. We just seen her make the three. So they finding the good shots. They've seen Henrietta Wells get to the goal off a pick and roll. It just got blocked. They have wide open shots they could make, but it's just not knocking them down.
Here's Palmer from the outside. No good. Rebound. Loose ball. Here come the Braves. Alexis Freeman looks for Wells. Wells off the window. And 25-18, and the lead is cut down to 7. You just talked about it. I guess they must have heard you.
I guess I'm talking too loud through the headphones. Do I need to quiet down a little bit? But no, that's what you need to see right there with Alcorn. Force TSU to take tough shots and get on the break.
Here's Artavia Ford off the glass. Misses the shot on the inside, gets her own rebound. Now I think they may inbound the basketball.
I think they should go to the free throw line. I think she was going up with that one. I think they'll go to the free throw.
I thought she was going up too, but the referee I think sees otherwise.
I guess that's why we're not wearing the black and white pinstripe shirts.
It's hard to be the zebra.
It is. It is. Tell me about it. I was at the YMCA for 2 years, 2013 and 2014. That's hard. Reference 5 year olds.
And those are 5 year olds.
Exactly. They're on 8 foot goals. And his parents get mad at me because I'm calling the wrong call. What am I supposed to do? They're 5 years old.
Here's Artavia Ford. Looks near side baseline. And Tigers safe. Tigers lead it by 7. Tigers 12-4 in SWAC play. Trying to get win number 13 here tonight. Here's Smith inside the 4. Shot is up, and quick foul there by the Lady Braves.
And you see on that free throw line when Kaylin Palmer had the ball in the wing, you seen Nicole Smith come around to the free throw line, not looking to score when she was calling for the ball, but she sees Artavia Ford sealing her opponent and had the easy layup. So great IQ by Nicole Smith coming around to the free throw line, getting the ball and giving it to Artavia Ford in the post.
Kenderson to Palmer. Buckets. Count the basket. 28-18, and the Lady Tigers extend the lead back to 10.
Great shot by Kaylin Palmer in that baseline. Her sweet spot is that baseline shot.
Here's Freeman. Freeman with the jump shot. I like her stroke. As Kirkland tries to go back up strong. The Braves will have to reset. Alexis Freeman. From Navasota, Texas, right up the road. Here's Freeman, playing in front of her home crowd. Can't hang on to it. Here come the Lady Tigers. Joyce Kenderson diving. 9 left on the shot clock. They have a little time left. Here's Wells. Wells with the move on forward. Count the bucket.
Great shot from Wells now. Wells has to finish those on a consistent basis now. Now she probably found her sweet spot. Last 4 buckets she had was in the paint, knocking down her layups now.
28-20. Lady Tigers trying to keep this lead going into the locker room. Here's Kenderson on the lane. And Kenderson is fouled. She'll go to the free throw line to shoot, too.
Can you talk about the 11 foul outs from Henrietta Wells? I think I can say that's one of the reasons why she gets fouled out a lot. Because she averaged 3 blocks per game, which is leading the SWAC. But 11 foul outs is a lot for a player as a post player. 11 foul outs in have 18 games of swag. So 11 out of 18 games, well, 17 games now, that you have to find a way, don't come down when you're blocking the ball.
Joyce Kenderson hits free throw number one. Make the score 29-20. Shamiah Brooks coming into the contest for the Lady Tigers. She'll come in for Artavia Ford. Joyce Kenderson trying to extend the lead to 10, and she does. 30-20. Your score. Here comes Alexis Freeman. The Lady Braves trying to score a couple of more points before they head into the locker room. Freeman. Thought about it. Here's Wells, top of the key. Wells driving. Left side. Here's Sanders. No. And rebound, Lady Tigers. I think they'll play for the last shot. Unless Kenderson takes it. Coast to coast. No. Loose ball. Here come the Braves. Sherman. And last touch out of bounds by the Lady Tigers.
And if you're Joyce Kenderson, you have to slow the ball up. But, you know, watching Joyce Kenderson, she loves going over the speed limit. She loves going 90 and the 60. But if you're Joyce Kenderson, you want to slow the ball up. You're up by 10 points, 19 seconds left at that time. You just want to slow that ball up. Now 6 seconds left with Alcorn State. Have a chance to bring it down a single digit before halftime.
Kenderson takes a breather before she goes into the locker room. 6 seconds left. Here's Freeman. Freeman with 5, 4, 3, finger roll. Loose ball. Wells going up. No good. Rebound. Last touch. And that will be the end of the first half. Great job there by the Lady Tigers as they take a 10-point lead going into the locker room. I'm sure we're going to hear from head coach Janita Hayes-Perry or the assistant coach. Great job there by the Lady Tigers in the first half.
Great job by Lady Tigers. Great job by Joyce Kenderson as always. Double-digit points for her on pace to get 20-25. And then sometimes we always say they need to find a second scorer. But some of these games like this, Joyce Kenderson, if she can take over, then let her be.
Let's go live on the sidelines down with Marcus Smith.
Here with assistant coach Carlos Wilson. Coach Wilson, first half, what'd you think about the Lady Tigers play out there?
Hey, you know, we got off to a quick start, and that's something that we talked about, something that we worked on, something that we told them that was really important, that we got off on the right track, and we did that. We kind of had a lull in the second half, but overall, we guarded them really well, and then we got the ball downhill, and we did some positive things. We just looked to carry that over the second half.
In the first half, talk about the hot start from Kenderson and Palmer. They combined for 22 of the team's first half, 30 points. What are we going to do to get a third scorer out there to get to kind of put the stamp on this game?
You know, our third scorer will be Chyna Ewan getting in and going downhill, and Artavia Ford or one of our other bigs in the post, or Briasia at the high post. So I think, you know, we'll get another one to go along with them, and hopefully we can finish this.
And then one more question. Defensively, number 15, what kind of job have the ladies been doing on her? Have you liked what they've been doing so far?
Yeah. We knew early on when we played them the first time, she won two dribble pull-ups and got to her spots and rose up. We kind of made it tough for her. We're trying to force her downhill where she's going to have to finish over some length. So I think overall, we did a good job guarding her.
All right, thank you, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
Thank you.
Nick, Akil, back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Marcus Smith on the sidelines. Akil, let's take a break. It's halftime here, and when we return, more second half action from the H&PE Arena. It's the Lady Tigers 30 and the Ladies Braves of Alcorn State 20. We'll be right back. You're watching Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network.
Experience like no other. From the 100% customization to the true lifetime guarantee, we identify the traditional four C's: cut, color, clarity, and carat. But Capture is something only Uptown Diamond provides. Capture is a diamond's intangible ability to accurately reflect you and the special person receiving your custom jewelry. You've captured her heart. Now, take her breath away. We'll be right back.
This is where crisp, smooth, refreshing Bud Light happens. But it is right here that it becomes an invitation. Making this not only 12 ounces of refreshment, but also 12 ounces of inspiration. To be more up for whatever than ever.
Bud Light!
The perfect beer for reading and unleashing a whole world of whatever in the name of a ridiculously good time. If you're up for whatever, look for your message on Bud Light bottles. Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens.
Think.
Question.
Cut.
Compare.
Learn something new.
Debunk something old.
Hit a wall.
And think again.
Model. Plan.
Spin.
Discard.
Now breathe. And keep going.
Work till it's late.
Then early.
Then late again.
Smile.
Laugh.
Rest.
Regroup.
Use technology.
Use your hands.
Use everything you've got.
That's what it takes.
Define the fabric of a team. It's not selfish. It's not boastful. It's about many, sewn together to reach one common goal. But in order to win, you must learn to work together.
I'm Percy Crusoe. If you haven't been to French's Chicken, or if it's been a while since your last visit, no place does chicken like French's. Our chicken is seasonized with our blend of Creole herbs and spices. Our side dishes include the tastiest greens and red beans and rice you'll ever put in your mouth. Try our new King Row Rotisserie Chicken at our Scotch Street location. Come on by French's Chicken, where the taste lasts forever.
Hello, I'm Alan Helfman, Vice President of River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge. This is my friend and customer, Ms. Georgia Provost. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Chrysler 300. River Oaks Chrysler Jeep and Dodge has the all-new, totally redesigned Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Alan is the only car dealer I will ever buy a car from.
Come see us at Kirby in the Southwest Freeway.
My name is Zach. My mom works, so I ride Metro 52 to school every day. I'm the drum major for Cashmere High School's Thunder Soul Marching Band. Every time I hit the field, it's like a dream. I just feed off the energy. But my real dream is to go from the Thunder Soul to the Ocean of Soul at TSU. And Metro's gonna take me there. I'm Zach, and this is my Metro.
Make the right moves, a rockin' movie.
Welcome back to Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. Nick Strong alongside Akia Williams, and Tigers lead it 30-20 here. Akia, let's get into some of those first half highlights. It was all Caitlin Palmer and Joyce Kinnerson.
Now we look at the replay. You see China Yu on the end of man-to-man. You see Caitlin Palmer knocking down that quick three early in the first half. You see on this play, Joyce Kinnerson coming down the court. Same thing, man-to-man, that switch from the zone. Going to Caitlin Palmer. Off the screen, Octavia Ford. Go to the lane, floater. Too easy for Caitlin Palmer. And on this replay right here, we see Caitlin Palmer inbound the ball to Joyce Kinnerson. Arm going out to the baseline for the easy jumper. Water. Easy for Caitlin Palmer. We see Caitlin Palmer in this game. 8 points, 3-for-9 shooting, and 2-for-6 from three-point range. Total up by 10, 30-20. 41% shooting for TSU. Alcorn State, 9-for-32. Only 28% from the field for Alcorn State.
30-20, you're scoring. That's how we end up here. Alcorn Braves just didn't get off to a good start here early on the kill.
They just didn't. They couldn't find their offense. We seen in the first quarter, they tried to pressure TSU. That wasn't working. They tried to hit a zone against TSU. That wasn't working. TSU was making the shots that Alcorn wasn't capitalizing on their offensive end of the ball.
And as the Lady Tigers get set to defend the Braves, the Alcorn State Lady Braves will go from left to right in your computer screen. 30-20, your score. Lady Tigers looking for their 13th win in SWAC. Sits in second place behind the Grambling State Tigers. Here's Henrietta Wells, guarded by Brooks. Lexus Freeman. 10 left on the shot clock. Here's rushing. And loose ball. Here come the Lady Tigers. Kinnerson will reset things here. And she almost whistled for a traveling violation. Joyce Kinnerson leads with 14 points. Palmer with the baseline shot. And great job there by rushing as she tipped the ball to herself in the front court. And trying to bang it off the window, she does. 20-2-30 is your score.
And if you're Alcorn State, you do not want to start off the second half with a turnover. In that first half, you turned the ball over 9 times. TSU turned the ball over 12 times. You see a steal by Alcorn State.
And Alexis Freeman cleans up the Aisha Kirkland missed layup.
But if you're the Lady Braves, you want to start off the second half good and a good start. Force TSU to take bad shots because that's not working right now for the Lady Tigers.
16 left on the shot clock. Here's Ewing. Five, four. Kinnerson will have to pull up. Shot is up with the floater. No good. And the Braves come away with it. 30-24, the Braves trying to come out with the surge here. They trail by 6. Here's Wells. Wells into the lane. Wells off the window, and Wells count the bucket. 30-26.
Miss Fundamental. When she knocks down a shot, it is sweet. It is soulful. Nice fundamental bucket from Henrietta Wells.
Here's Palmer. No. Rebound Brooks. Brooks goes
great
back
rebound.
Up strong. Here's McElrath. No. And she'll go to the free throw line and shoot the two.
Like I said in the first half, talking to Caitlin Palmer, I guess she needed a hand in her face with that shot because she was too wide open. Good shot from her. Probably could have took it down a couple of steps for the mid-range, but it was a great shot overall and great rebound from McElrath.
Breezy McElrath to the free throw line, shooting 54% of the season, 51-for-94. Make it 52-for-95. You take statistics on this campus, son?
Man, statistics are too hard. Math, I don't even touch math. You know, I'm glad I got that done with 2 years ago. I'm not a math guy, science guy. I stick to what I love to do, my passion. Math, statistics, algebra, that's too much for me.
Shot is up from the outside by Lutton. And rebound, here come the Lady Tigers. They lead by 6. Janita Hayes-Perry in her 4th year here at Texas Southern. Ewing gets it off to Kinnerson. Kinnerson to the lane. Kinnerson off the glass, and she's fouled. She'll go to the free throw line and shoot the two.
In that first half, we've seen Joyce Kinnerson go to the free throw line 4 times. She's going to go 5 and 6, for number 5 and number 6 today. in the second half. So you got to love Joyce Kennison's aggression. Get into that hole. She can score three-point line, mid-range, close range, whatever. She can take it between the wolves and trees.
The wolves and trees?
That was bad analogy. Oh. That was horrible. It came to my mind. I was going to say
trees.
You've
been watching Twilight or something? Or?
Nah, I don't want to discuss all the Twilight stuff right now, but that was bad. Watching a lot of sci-fi movies.
All right.
I just seen Get Out. That's why. I seen okay. The wolves and trees. That's why I get it from. That's a great excuse I should have.
34-26. Lady Tigers lead it by 8. Here's Kirkland. Kirkland inside to Wells. Wells looks for rushing. Rushing. And shot is blocked by Brooks. Wow. Swats. And Wells gets it right back. 8 left on the shot clock. Here's Freeman. And an offensive foul on Alexis Freeman. As she goes over Joyce Kennison. And I think that may be a little bit of home cooking. You just can't knock over Joyce Kennison like that.
Not at all. You know, that was a great IQ, great knowledge of where to get to the place for Joyce Kennison to step in front of Alexis Freeman to cause that charge.
That's 3 fouls on Alexis Freeman, the junior from Navasota, Texas.
And that's big, because Alexis Freeman is your key player. Outside of Henrietta Wells, Alexis Freeman is your perimeter scorer. Last 4 games hasn't been the same, but that if you lose her with 3 fouls right now in the second half, that is very big for the Braves.
Artavia Ford into the lane, count the bucket. 36-26, and the Lady Tigers extend the lead back to 10.
And now if you're Joyce Kennison, you're knowing that Alexis Freeman has 3 fouls. Look for Joyce Kennison to attack the paint more and try to get Alexis Freeman on fouls number 4 and 5 in this game.
Tia Sanders pushes the point here for the Braves from Pensacola, Florida, a long way from home. Pensacola down the I-10 coast. Here come the Lady Tigers. Joyce Kennison. Loose ball, jump ball. Maybe the Alcorn State Braves have called a timeout. No, they're going to give it a jump ball. Tigers basketball here going from right to left.
And great defense, great hustle that you've seen from Joyce Kennison, China Ewing, Brazier McArrow, Shamal Brooks. They all playing great ball on the defensive side of the ball. They know scoring is not the most important, but hustling and defense will be key down the stretch for this game and towards the playoffs.
Here come the Lady Tigers. They lead it by 10. Great drive by Kennison. Count it. Lady Tigers led last time these two teams met. Had a down second half. Tigers trying to capitalize this time. Can they have a better second half than they did last time down in Alcorn, Mississippi? You talked about it early on. Tigers getting up, then getting down. Can they maintain the consistency, or can they be consistent throughout the contest?
And you're seeing that right now, Nick, with the Lady Tigers. They played the first half really well. A couple of hiccups, but it happens in basketball. Had 12 turnovers. Now you're seeing the third quarter. They're playing a very solid basketball right now through the first half and now in the third quarter. If you're the Lady Tigers fans, you love watching what you're seeing right now for the Lady Tigers.
Here's Kirkland. Puts it up top for Lutton. Hargrove to the lane. Ball stolen. Here comes Ewing. Gets it to Kennison. Kennison, yes! Count the basket. 40-26 is your score.
And another 20-point performance from Joyce Kennison as well.
Joyce Kennison. 20 points. Player of the Week honors. I don't know. Maybe. Here's a shot by Sanders. No good. Out of bounds, Lady Tiger basketball. Lady Tigers extend the lead to 14 here. Kennison was named SWAC Player of the Week last week after a great performance at home. Ewing to Ford. Ford inside to McElrath. McElrath, yes! Count it! 42-26. And the Lady Tigers extend the lead to 16. Media timeout on the floor. Lady Tigers 40. The Lady Braves of Alcorn State 26. You're listening to Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network.
Where crisp, smooth, refreshing Bud Light happens. But it is right here that it becomes an invitation. Making this not only 12 ounces of refreshment, but also 12 ounces of inspiration. To be more up for whatever than ever.
Bud Light!
The perfect beer for reading and unleashing a whole world of whatever in the name of a ridiculously good time. If you're up for whatever, look for your message on Bud Light bottles. Bud Light, the perfect beer for whatever happens.
Think.
Question.
Cut.
Compare.
Learn something new.
Debunk something old.
Hit a wall.
And think again.
Model. Plan.
Spin.
Discard.
Now breathe. And keep going.
Work till it's late.
Then early.
Then late again.
Smile.
Laugh.
Rest.
Regroup.
Use technology.
Use your hands.
Use everything you've got.
That's what it takes.
Welcome back to Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. West Coast tonight. I think Marcus Smith may have got to the DJ.
He had to. I would not be surprised at all knowing Marcus Smith probably did request a West Coast song.
42-26, Lady Tigers lead it by 16. Breasia McElrath to the free throw line. And she shoots one. Looking for a three-point play. And we just can't get it. Artavia Ford with the save.
Great hustle.
To McElrath. Great job there by the Lady Tigers on that possession.
They're seeing great hustle from TSU all night long, and it's still going on with a 16-point lead.
Here's Palmer. Ford on the dribble. And Breasia McElrath. And there you have it again. McElrath, I guess, got caught pushing off. But not really.
Quote, unquote. Like I say, it's kind of hard to ref Breasia McElrath at times because she's so ultra-aggressive. Arguably the most aggressive player in all of SWAC, along with Shamal Brooks. But McElrath just plays 150% every single night, and it's kind of hard to ref against her.
Here's Spann. And into the game now is Jubenville. And Jubenville with the deuce. Jubenville all the way from Alberta, Canada. The freshman recruiting internationally here.
Out the country. Great find.
Southern with some international players. Alcorn with a couple. Well, one rather. Here's Kenderson to the lane. Oh, my goodness. Count the bucket.
Great move. Great move. You see her lay up with the left hand so many times, you would think she's left-handed, but surprisingly not for the watch, for the viewers watching. She's right-handed, people. Going with the left hand all the time.
Shot is blocked by Ford. And the ref called a foul there. Let's go live down to Marcus Smith on the sidelines.
Hey, guys. Over the break, Coach Perry was just talking about fundamentals on defense, making sure you're in help when the ball's on the weak side. Other than that, keep playing the game that they're playing. They're up big right now. She wants them to continue their dominance out there, continue to swing the ball on offense to make easy shots. One thing she was really particular about was staying calm. Also talked to the assistant coach, Nathaniel Bell. He said some of the same things. In that second quarter earlier, too many turnovers. If they could just stay poised on offense, it'll be in the bag easily for them. Back to you guys.
One of the things he talked about was staying poised out there, Kia. With a 14-point lead out there, you definitely don't want to lose your composure. You definitely have to keep playing the game of basketball the way you play it from the first quarter all the way to the fourth quarter.
And we've seen times with the Lady Tigers that they would have a double-digit lead but blow it. And they would come out with the victory at times, but you will see from time to time with TSU that they would have a lead and slump like these with fouls, turnovers, bad shot selection. You will see Lady Tigers sometimes be in that funk, and it will hurt them, even though they come out with the victory.
And here's Caitlin Palmer whistle for the offensive foul here. 44-30, your score. And we got a score down from Alabama State, 47-34, as they lead the Grambling State Lady Tigers by 13. We talked about it earlier. Grambling loses. The Tigers have a spot, have a chance to take the first place seed. We talked about that earlier.
And that's huge. And that's huge for the Tigers. If they can hold on to this lead, and if Alabama State can hold on to that lead, you will see TSU with that first place spot going into the next, to the last game of the season against Southern. So that's a big, big stat update.
From the producer himself, Mr. Charles McClellan.
Charles
executive producer himself. That's still on the Grambling stream. As we know, the Grambling Tigers stream their games as well. Like to send a shout out down to Grambling, Louisiana.
Yeah.
So let's get it straight one more time. Grambling is 13-3. The Lady Tigers are 12-4. Lady Tigers win tonight, they'll be 13-4, tied with Grambling if they lose at 13-4. That means the winner of Saturday's games, well, I think Grambling will hold the tiebreaker. We'll have to break that. Well, they do hold the tiebreaker because they swept the Lady Tigers. So if Grambling lose both contests this weekend, Lady Tigers win two, we'll be in the mix for the first place win.
And that's big. They just got to finish this game out strong. So does Alabama State, because we're praying on Alabama State. We beat them this past weekend, but we're rooting for them tonight. And they have to win big tonight, and you also have to look at the play for next set, for this Saturday as well against Southern.
And Alabama State, not a bad team?
Not at all. Not at all. But I said coming into the season that Alabama State losing their players and still keeping Brittany Wright. Brittany Wright is the new Noreana Haynes of the SWAC. She does have a lot of help in Alabama State, and she's still playing at a top three level, top-notch ball for Alabama State, but she's in the same position that Alcorn's very own Noreana Haynes was in this season. But they still having a good season overall.
44-34, and to the free throw line is Tori Spann. Tori Spann, count the bucket, shooting 58% on the year. She was 39 for 67, make it 40 for 68 now. You said you didn't like stats, right? Statistics class, huh?
Oh, no, I can't do it. I can do statistics when it comes to sports. Football, basketball, boxing, whatever. I can do stats. But when it comes to math and sitting down, break down the equation, that's not me.
44-36, Lady Tigers trying to bring it home tonight. Over the Lady Braves of Alcorn State from Lorman, Mississippi. Shana Ewing to the lane and count it. Extends the lead to 10. Have you taken a trip to Alcorn yet?
No, I haven't. I'm looking forward to that. Hopefully the next couple of years while I'm still at TSU, and for the future, I would love to, since we went to Alabama, I would love to go to Mississippi for a trip.
Try going during homecoming.
No, I wouldn't mind. I wouldn't mind.
Here's Chyna Ewing to the baseline. Looking for Kenderson, and she passes up on the shot. She'll reset. Lady Tigers lead it by 10. Just about a minute left to go here in the third quarter. Here's Kenderson. No, just missed. Grambling won the first game 69-61. Excuse me, the second game. Excuse me. TSU won the first game 69-61. And TSU lost the second game 64-52. So they both. So the way you do the SWAC standings and you break a tie, you take the head-to-head. Then the next is the point total differential. So with that being said, 69-61 is an 8-point win for the Lady Tigers. 64-52 is a 12-point win for the Grambling State Tigers. So actually, they hold the tiebreaker. I was thinking 62-54. So the Grambling State Tigers hold the tiebreaker because the point differential is 12 minus 8 is 4 points to the Grambling State Tigers.
Yeah, so basically now Grambling State has to lose not only this game but the game Saturday.
Yes.
And TSU need to hold on to the lead tonight and win against Southern. So hopefully we need Grambling State to lose tonight and Saturday.
I think I was the one who should have went to statistics class.
I think, yeah, you should have went. Yeah, no, I'm glad I ain't touched that
class. Old age catching up with me. That's what it is. 47-36. Lady Tigers trying to put it in the bag here. As Camille Mills comes into the contest. We haven't seen her in a while. Here's Ewing. Mills on a reset. Pick set by Smith. Mills looks left side for Ewing. Ewing at the baseline. Shot is up. No. Loose ball. Rebound. It's Mills. and Tigers will play for the last shot here. They'll clear it out for Kenderson. 7, 6, 5. Kenderson, 4, 3, 2. No. Rebound, Jubenville. And the Lady Tigers lead it by 11 going into the locker room. 47-36, your score. You're watching Lady Tiger basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. I sent you that. This is the way they determine the point. Fourth quarter here at the H&P Arena. Nick Strong alongside Akia Williams, Marcus Smith on the sidelines. And the Lady Tigers lead this one 47-36. Here's Jubenville to the lane. Shot is up over McElrath. Count the bucket. The lead is cut to 9. Time to start voting for your player of the game. Akia, we're going to go interactively tonight, and we're going to let the people inside the broadcast who's watching the broadcast at home vote for your player of the game.
Oh.
So you can vote for Joyce Kenderson. You can vote for Briasia McElrath. You can vote for Caitlin Palmer. Just type your comment or type the name inside the comments.
Is Marcus Smith's suits involved in this, in the voting?
I don't know.
Because man, the brother is short. The all-black suit coat, the suit coat.
Shemiah Brooks puts it in for 2. Count the basket. 49-38 to score. Lady Tigers still lead it by 11 here. Here's a shot by Span, and Span getting her own rebound one time. She just can't hang on to it. Joyce Kenderson leads the way. She's the only player tonight on both teams in double digits.
So I think the fans have spoken without getting the vote back, the vote results back. I think Joyce Kenderson is the player of the game, 23 points, 7 for 13 shooting, 3 assists, 1 steal. If I had a vote, I'd vote for Joyce Kenderson.
If I had a vote, I'd vote for Joyce Kenderson too. 49-38 and a loose ball. Last touch by Joyce Kenderson. Kind of fumbled it around just a little bit. Just about 8.5 left to go here in the fourth quarter. Let's talk about it down the stretch, Akil. Who are the Lady Tigers? Who are the Lady Braves rely on going into the lane?
Well, you're looking at the Lady Braves. We just had no consistent offense throughout the whole game. A total shooting 15 for 45 with 33.3%. So it's hard to say who you go to down the stretch because nobody really stood out. But the leading scorers in this game, you got to look at Henrietta Wells with 8, Alexis Freeman with 6. So really just got to find a way, find a hot hand because nobody really had a hot hand this whole entire game.
On the other side of the basketball, the Lady Tigers, Joyce Kenderson leads the way with 23. We know she's the player to watch, but how do the other Lady Tigers get into the game to help her?
Well, I look at, like I said before the game, I look at Caitlin Palmer. 8 points, 3 for 11 shooting. Kind of an off night for her back at home. But because we know night in and night out, Joyce Kenderson is the most consistent player scoring the ball.
Here's Ewing with the rebound, going up strong. Shot was blocked by Wells and just couldn't put it in on the tip back. Her Here comes Rushing. And Rushing will reset inside. Here's Freeman. Lady Braves will reset. They trail by 11 points here. Freeman to the lane. Up and under. No. Rebound. Henrietta Wells. Loose ball. Rushing. And here comes the jump ball. Actually, it may be a loose ball again. The refs let them play right there. Kenderson. And she'll have to slow it down. Locker. 49-38. Here's Ewing. A little motion here by the Lady Tigers. Kenderson to the lane. Kenderson off the glass. Kenderson into the bucket. 51-38, and the Lady Tigers take a 13-point lead.
Watching Joyce Kenderson play every day, every game. She makes it look easy with the left hand because I'm left-handed. And I think to myself, like, man, I couldn't do half the things she can do. And I'm left-handed, but she's right-handed. So yes. That's kind of – I feel kind of bad. But, hey, Joyce Kenderson, 25 points. She's a marvelous scorer. Once again, she might catch 30.
She needs five more.
She'll get it.
Artavia Ford comes back into the contest. Great job by Shamira Brooks tonight. You don't really see her too live in the stat line, but she got the start tonight, and she was able to make an impact again.
Yeah, she's been getting the start the last five games. I think due to her aggressiveness and her presence in the paint, Shamira Brooks is an impact and pose a factor against other teams, you know, because not a lot of post players are – there's not a lot of big post players in the SWAC, you know, and I think Shamira Brooks is a big impact for this Lady Tigers team.
Henrietta Wells cleans up the mess, puts it back in the bucket for a deuce, 51-40. Out. 15 left on the shot clock. Here's Kenderson. Shot is blocked by Wells. Leading shot blocker in the SWAC. Freeman to Wells. Wells off the glass. And a collision there by Wells and Ewing. If I didn't say so myself, I think they were related. Wells and Ewing.
You think so? Is there a conspiracy theory behind this? Let me know something.
China Ewing from Little Rock, Arkansas. Henrietta Wells from Memphis, Tennessee, right down the road.
So you're saying they're distance cousins?
Maybe third cousins.
Maybe. A little conspiracy theory behind that.
Here's Joyce Kenderson, and a quick foul off the ball. It's going to go against the Lady Braves, Brianna Lutton, number 12. She's also playing in front of her hometown squad, or her hometown crowd, the senior from Westside High School, Houston Independent School District.
Nice 4A school.
6A.
Oh, they 6A now.
6A.
Oh, times has changed. Oh, my goodness.
China Ewing. Here's Kenderson. Buckets. 54-40. And Joyce Kenderson has 28 points. And Tia Sanders trying to answer. And she doesn't put it inside the bucket. Here's Ford. Ford just picks it up. Here's Palmer. Palmer looks for Kenderson. Kenderson trying to hit 30. Media timeout coming up at the next dead ball. Here's Ewing to the lane. And a quick foul there by, looks like it's going to be on number 20, Tia Sanders. It's going to be her first. Media timeout on the floor. 54-40 is your score. And the Lady Tigers lead it by 14. We'll be right back. You're watching Lady Tiger Basketball only on the TSU. Welcome back to Lady Tiger Basketball here on the TSU Sports Network. Nick Strong alongside Akia Williams, Marcus Smith on the sidelines. 54-40, your score, Akia, and it's been the Tigers thus far. Joyce Kennerson, 28 points is the key to tonight's game.
28 points for Joyce Kennerson. Another potential 30-point performance. And you got to look at Alcorn throughout the whole game. They never found a consistent offense. They had the defense throughout the first half, but then the second half, TSU just took off and capitalized off of Lady Braves' mistakes on the opposite side of the ball.
Joyce Kennerson loses the basketball in a backcourt violation as China Ewing just couldn't put it where she wanted it. 54-40, and the Lady Braves have possession going from left to right of your computer screen. Rolling down the stretch here, Akil, the last 5 minutes of this fourth quarter, possibly the contest, the Braves are trying to get back into the contest. What are you telling your Lady Braves if you're head coach Courtney Pruitt right now?
Just finish the game. Play hard. It's four and a half minutes left in the game. Just play hard, play tough. You know, you're down double digits. It's going to be hard to find a way to come back in this game. And just finish out the game. Finish out strong.
Here's Freeman from 14. Bucket. 54-42. Let's go live to Marcus Smith on the sidelines real quick.
Hey, guys. One of the players that's been standing out, of course, Joyce Kennison. She has 28 points. But like I talked to Coach Wilson after half, we're looking for the next somebody to step up, whether it's Caitlin Palmer, Artavia Ford. We have to see some of that as they maintain a 12-point lead. We've seen the Lady Tigers slip from these big games, from these big leads late. So we'll see what they do later in the quarter. Back to you guys.
And that's always the key. Can the Lady Tigers hang on to the lead here in the fourth quarter with 3 minutes and 48 seconds left to go here? It's not an overcoming feat, but can they maintain, can they do it the things that they need to do to keep this lead? Fresh shot clock for the Tigers. Here's Ford. Ford into the lane. Up and under, bucket. 56-42, and the Lady Tigers lead it by 14.
And I think to answer your question, they can close out the game, but the real question I have for TSU going to tournament time, can they find that second score? Because if you want to beat a team like Grambling that you might see in the championship, can you find that number two score when the lights are on bright, Toyota Center, March 10th or March 11th? If you play against a team like Grambling, can you find that consistent score? Because you have three scores in Grambling that you know they could count on. In Neil, Jasmine Boyd, and Kyla Hill. TSU, 21 points per game with Joyce Kennison. But who's second? Is it Caitlin Palmer? Is it Artavia Ford off the bench? Or is it a China Ewing?
8 seconds left on the shot clock. Artavia Ford off the window. Buckets. 58-42, and the lead is extended now to 16. So Lady Tigers trying to pull off the double sweep this weekend. And Henrietta Wells just couldn't put it in the bucket there. Lady Tigers trying to go for the win tonight. Hopefully Saturday night they win too. They'll be 14-4. Possibly if Grambling State loses to Alabama State tonight and A&M on Saturday, the Lady Tigers could win the number one seed. Here's Kennerson, and my gosh, Akil, she has 30 points.
Another 30-point performance from Joyce Kennerson. It's just quite amazing watching Joyce Kennerson play game in and game out, and she's only a sophomore.
And she also just met her career high, 30 points here for the sophomore from Port Arthur, Texas.
Got to give credit to Coach Hayes Perry. Question is, where did you find her? My goodness, what a steal in recruiting Joyce Kennison. And I've seen it happen when I seen NeNe go down last year, Dominisha Sobers go down, and the freshman had to take over and take the starting point guard role as a freshman. And ever since then, she did not look back.
As I'm looking on the chat line, and I'm seeing Joyce Kennerson for player of the game. I even saw a Nick Strong player of the game.
Oh, you
here.
Got a fan, man. You have a fan base. Uh-oh.
60-42. Lady Tigers trying to close it out here. Kennerson with 30. Looking for more career highs tonight. Kalina Morris gets set to check into the contest. Here's Kennerson. Kennerson to the lane. Kennerson up and under. No. Loose ball. Here come the Braves. And China Ewing. Yes.
Great layup. Great and one play from Alexis Freeman. Tough night for her overall. A tough 5-game stretch she's been having. but you got to love the hustle and the heart from Alcorn State.
Alexis Freeman to the free throw line to attempt a three-point play. She makes it. 60-45. Lady Tigers lead by 15. Here's Kinnerson. 30 points for the sophomore from Port Arthur, Texas. And I think she's only come out one time then. Here's the pick. Kinnerson to the lane. No. Rebound, Brooks. Brooks, yes! 62-45. Here's Jubenville off the glass. Rebound, McElrath. Lady Tigers, a minute and 10 seconds closer to tying the Grambling State Tigers. And a quick timeout here by head coach Janeda Hayes-Perry. We'll keep it right here. Maybe we can take a look at some replays, but Akil, as we take a look at this last 1 minute and 9 seconds here for the Lady Tigers, Joyce Kinnerson has led the way. We answered the question, did the Lady Tigers play well going down the stretch into the fourth quarter?
They did. They did. You see, they kept the lead, have a 17-point lead, and all night long with Joyce Kinnerson, Alcorn State could not find a way to stop and contain Joyce Kinnerson. As we go to the replays here, you see the cross pass, cross court to Joyce Kinnerson with the easy three on that play. Down the fast break, China Ewan, you see the Joyce Kinnerson. And Joyce Kinnerson all night long was just a person you just could not stop. Three-pointers, mid-range, and ones. It was just hard to stop her all night long. And Joyce Kinnerson right now is playing lights out all season long, and she got my vote for player of the year.
You know, on the other side of the basketball, Akil, the Alcorn State Braves, they'll be in the tournament. They will be there. They'll more than likely match up against Alabama State this weekend, or excuse me, next Tuesday in the first, or Tuesday in the first round. How do you like their chances in the playoffs?
Well, they got to find somebody. They have to find a score. These five games for Alexis Freeman, she came into the game. She came into the season 14 points per game this season, and these last five games, she's been shooting 30%. And for them to find a way, they match it with Alabama State, who has a player in Brittany Wright, who's a top two, top three player in the SWAC. You have to find scoring.
Here's Kinnerson with five left on the shot clock. Kinnerson will let it fly. No, it's going to be Camille Mills. No. I thought Kinnerson was going to let it fly with the shot clock running down. Quick pass, though. Here's a shot by Freeman. Shot is blocked by Kinnerson. As Freeman gets it right back. Here's Span. Span from 18. Rebound. Isis Lane. Shot clock is turned off. And the Lady Tigers. The Lady Tigers going to go for their 13th victory here. And there's Kalina Morris trying to head into the point column. And she does. Kalina Morris from Greensboro, North Carolina, in her first year here at Texas Southern. And the Braves will just let it fly. 64-45, and the Lady Tigers win it. I think Joyce Kinnerson wins the player of the game. The fans wanted it. They got it. Akil, 30 points tonight for Joyce Kinnerson, and she looked good doing it.
She looked good doing it. Easy 30 points for Joyce Kinnerson. You got to give credit to Alcorn State because it's not easy to come to the H&PE Arena and defeat a team like TSU that's on the road, one of the hottest teams right now in SWAC. They know what's at stake. They know they have a chance to be first place in the SWAC, and they have a game Saturday night against Southern, the Lady Jaguars. Well, hey, that's going to be an even bigger game going into SWAC time.
The alma mater. It's always refreshing to hear that song after a Lady Tiger victory here. Akil, the Lady Tigers will match up against the Southern Jaguars Saturday night, and that looks to be a good one as well. It's a must-win for the Lady Tigers with Grambling still losing right now in the fourth quarter to the Alabama State Hornets.
Well, you've seen last time they played against Southern was on the road. One in overtime, 77-71. And in that time period with TSU, the lineup was different, the depth was different, because the first four games in conference for TSU, they squeaked out of victories. It wasn't blowouts, they didn't have no dominant performance. But you look at TSU, last game before tournament time, they know how big that game is. And TSU gonna come in focused and prepare like always.
Let's go to Marcus Smith on the sidelines. I think he has the player of the game. My favorite Lady Tiger, number 3, Joyce Kennerson.
Maru, the great player of the game, Joyce Kennerson. Today, I'm not sure.